Cold War II, the NATO beast, the American eagle, the Russian bear, and the Great Tribulation Wars. The Cold War between the United States and Russia was reignited when Russia invaded Ukraine on February 24, 2022, against the protests of the United States and the NATO alliance. Scripture prophecy declares that Cold War II between the United States and Russia is going to end in disaster for America. There are many theologians and theists who proclaim that mystical scripture prophecy cannot be interpreted and can only be understood in a symbolic sense. But with God, all things are possible. The Genesis account of Pharaoh's prophetic dreams, properly interpreted by Joseph, serves as an example that refutes the contention that allegoric prophetic dreams or visions cannot be accurately interpreted. Pharaoh had a dream, and behold, he stood by the river. Suddenly, there came up out of the river seven cows, fine-looking and fat. And they fed in the meadow. Then behold, seven other cows came up after them out of the river, ugly and gaunt. And stood by the other cows on the bank of the river. And the ugly and gaunt cows ate up the seven fine-looking and fat cows. So Pharaoh awoke. He slept and dreamed a second time. And suddenly, seven heads of grain came up on one stalk, plump and good. Then behold, seven thin heads, blighted by the east wind, sprang up after them, and the seven thin heads devoured the seven plump and full heads. It came to pass that Pharaoh was troubled over his dreams, and he summoned all the magicians and wise men of Egypt to interpret his dreams, but no one could interpret them. Then the chief butler told Pharaoh of an imprisoned Hebrew man, Joseph, who had interpreted his dream and that of the chief baker when they were imprisoned with Joseph, and Joseph's interpretation of their dreams came to pass, just as Joseph had interpreted them. Then Pharaoh sent for Joseph, and Joseph stood before him. Pharaoh told Joseph his dreams, and Joseph proceeded to accurately interpret them.
Now listen carefully. In my dream, there were seven cows, fat and sleek, and they grazed. I've never seen such poor cows in all of Egypt. But it was impossible to tell they had eaten the fat cows, for they looked as wretched as ever. In the second dream, there were seven ears of grain, beautifully ripe. Then sprouting up behind them were seven withered ears of grain, which devoured the ripe ones.
God has revealed to Pharaoh what he intends to do.
Yes?
Pharaoh's dreams are one and the same. The seven fine cows and seven ripe ears of grain represent 7 years of plenty. The seven wretched cows and seven shriveled ears of grain are years of great want. There will be 7 years of famine, my lord.
Pharaoh's dreams, recorded in Genesis 41, are forerunner examples of end times prophecies. The purpose of bringing up Joseph's interpretation of Pharaoh's prophetic dreams before deciphering and revealing end times prophecies in this presentation are threefold. 1. A person in whom is the Spirit of God can reveal allegoric end times prophetic dreams and visions, just as Joseph revealed Pharaoh's dreams. 2. Various end times dreams and visions are often related and are one, telling different versions of the same message of what is about to take place. Just as Joseph informed Pharaoh that his two dreams of seven fat cows consumed by seven gaunt cows and seven plump heads of grain were devoured by seven blighted thin heads of grain were one and the same message regarding the thing that God was about to do. 3. When something is repeated twice or more, or it is proclaimed by God, or it is written in scripture prophecy, it is established by God, and God will bring it to pass. Just as Joseph informed Pharaoh that his dreams were repeated to him twice, because the matter was established by God, and God would surely bring it to pass.
The seven fat cows and seven green ears mean 7 years of prosperity. And the seven thin cows and seven dry ears mean 7 years of drought and famine.
Well done. That's it. This interpretation is in exact harmony with my dream. That is it.
When Pharaoh heard Joseph's interpretation of his two dreams, he immediately knew that Joseph's explanation was in perfect harmony with his dreams. The dreams and visions of the four beasts of Daniel 7, the four horsemen of Revelation 6, and the first beast of Revelation 13 are one. These three prophecies are three different version warnings of end time events, just as Pharaoh's two dreams were two different version warnings of the severe famine that would come upon Egypt. The four beasts of Daniel 7, the four horsemen of Revelation 6, and the first beast of Revelation 13 are one, with only slight variations in the narratives, as the following comparative analysis will show. Daniel 7, verse 3 through 4, and four great beasts came up from the sea, each different from the other. The first was like a lion and had eagle's wings. Revelation 6, verse 2. And I looked, and behold, a white horse. He who sat on it had a bow, and a crown was given to him, and he went out conquering and to conquer. The first beast of Daniel, chapter 7, is a lion with eagle's wings. This beast represents the alliance of Great Britain and the United States during and after the conclusion of World War II. The lion is the national symbol of the United Kingdom, and the bald eagle is the national symbol of the United States of America. The lion with eagle's wings acquires many other nations unto itself through NATO. The first horse of Revelation 6 is a white horse. White is the color of the NATO symbol and the color of the United Nations emblem of the world surrounded by a wreath on a blue background. White is the color of UN vehicles that restore civil order after NATO military interventions in the nations. The first beast of Daniel 7, a lion with eagle's wings, and the white horse of Revelation 6 are one, NATO. The eagle's wings of the first beast of Daniel 7 and the rider of the white horse of Revelation 6 are one, the United States of America. The United States, through NATO, goes out conquering and to conquer, toppling regimes and to nation build. Daniel 7, verse 4. I watched till its wings were plucked off, and it was lifted up from the earth, and made to stand on 2 feet like a man, and a man's heart was given to it. Revelation 13, verse 2 through 3. Now the beast which I saw was like a leopard. His feet were like the feet of a bear, and his mouth like the mouth of a lion. The dragon gave him his power, his throne, and great authority. And I saw one of his heads as if it had been mortally wounded, and his deadly wound was healed. The eagle's wings plucked off the lion in Daniel 7 verse 4, and the deadly wound to one of the heads of the first beast of Revelation 13 verse 3 are one, the destruction of the United States. The NATO beast will survive having its wings plucked from it and will rapidly mobilize militarily and stand on its feet as a global superpower. Without the eagle's wings, America's military and financial support. The NATO beast is a multi-headed beast made up of many nations. The NATO beast will receive a deadly wound to one of its head nations, the United States. The NATO beast will survive the deadly wound that it receives to its empire, rapidly mobilize with strong military and financial support from France and Germany, and will go on to become the third and fourth beasts of Daniel 7. The current state of the NATO beast. A sculpture that was on display during the Gregorian calendar year 2021 outside the United Nations building in New York called Guardian for International Peace and Security is an accurate representation of the current state of the NATO beast. The NATO beast, or the New World Order, started as a lion with eagle's wings, the alliance of Great Britain and the United States during and after World War II. Then, after acquiring many nations unto itself, became the NATO beast as depicted by the sculpture, the Guardian for International Peace and Security. The Guardian for International Peace and Security sculpture features the same characteristics of the first beast described in Revelation 13, which are the body of a leopard representing Germany, the feet of a bear representing former Soviet bloc Eastern European nations, and the mouth of a lion representing Great Britain. The leopard is a secondary national symbol of Germany. Germany has been manufacturing Leopard battle tanks since 1965. The Guardian for International Peace and Security has one additional feature that the first beast of Revelation 13 does not have: eagle's wings, which represent the United States of America. 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 3. For when they say, peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them, as labor pains upon a pregnant woman, the guardian of peace and international security sculpture representing the current state of the NATO beast, led and supported by the United States, will have its eagle's wings suddenly plucked off. Then suddenly, a bear. Daniel 7, verse 5. And suddenly, another beast, a second, like a bear. It was raised up on one side, and had three ribs in its mouth, between its teeth. And they said thus to it, Arise, devour much flesh. Revelation 6, verse 4. Another horse, fiery red, went out, and it was granted to the one who sat on it to take peace from the earth, and that people should kill one another. And there was given to him a great sword. The second beast of Daniel 7, the bear, and the fiery red horse of Revelation 6 are one, Russia. The bear is the national symbol of the Russian Federation, and fiery red is the traditional national color of Russia. Russia is a lopsided bear that is raised up on one side, Western Russia, as 85% of the Russian population lives in the western half of Russia and 15% of the population lives in the eastern half of Russia. Russia suddenly takes peace from the earth by plucking the wings off the lion / destroying the rider of the white horse, the world's peacekeeper, the United States of America, with a great sword, its massive nuclear arsenal. Russia delivers a deadly wound to the first beast of Revelation 13, NATO, by destroying one of the head nations of the NATO beast, the United States. The eagle's wings plucked off the lion of Daniel 7, and the deadly wound to one of the heads of the multi-headed beast of Revelation 13 are one, the destruction of the United States. The bear, Russia, will devour much flesh when it destroys the United States with its nuclear arsenal. Peace will be taken from the earth, and many people will kill each other in the great tribulation wars that follow the destruction of the United States. America will not militarily retaliate against Russia. Jeremiah 50, verse 23, with interpretation. How the hammer of the whole earth, global superpower, has been cut apart and broken. Jeremiah 51, verse 26, with interpretation. Every one of their, America's, bows, nuclear missile silos, is broken. Revelation 18, verse 9 through 10, with interpretation. the kings of the earth who committed fornication and lived luxuriously with America will weep and lament for America when they see the smoke of America's burning, standing at a distance for fear of America's torment, military retaliation, saying, "Alas, alas, that great nation, America, that mighty nation." For in 1 hour, America's judgment has come. While the United States has built itself up to be the world's conventional war superpower nation, Russia has been developing EMP, electromagnetic pulse weapons, and hypersonic nuclear weapon missiles that are superior to America's defenses and nuclear capabilities. When Russia launches its attack against America, it will first immobilize America's mainland and nuclear naval fleet with EMP weapons, so that America will not be able to militarily retaliate against Russia's nuclear assault. Russia plans to avoid MAD, mutual assured destruction, and win a nuclear war against the United States. The stages of the NATO beast. The first, third, and fourth beasts of Daniel 7, the white horse and its rider of Revelation 6, and the first beast of Revelation 13 are one, the NATO beast. The first, third, and fourth beasts of Daniel 7 are the same beast at different stages of development. The bear of Daniel 7 verse 5, Russia, is the only beast that is not related to the other beasts of Daniel 7 and is the beast that opposes the NATO beast. The NATO beast will survive the deadly wound it receives to one of its head nations, the United States, which is destroyed by the bear, Russia. After the wings are plucked off the NATO beast, the NATO beast will become the third beast of Daniel 7, as it will acquire two new sets of wings, representing the support that the NATO beast will receive from the Franco-German alliance. The national symbols of France and Germany are the Gaelic rooster and the heraldic eagle, respectively. The NATO beast will then go on to become the fourth and final beast of Daniel 7, the final Roman Empire. The Great Tribulation Wars. Matthew 24, verse 7, Mark 13, verse 8, Luke 21, verse 10. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. When Russia destroys the United States, peace will be taken from the earth. The United States, the world's sole peacekeeper, the mighty conventional war superpower, will no longer exist to prevent regional wars from occurring. There will not be a World War III. Russia is prophesied to immobilize the United States with a surprise cyber and EMP attack, then suddenly destroy the United States. The United States will be immobilized and will not be able to launch a retaliatory nuclear strike against Russia. Scripture proclaims that there will be a great tribulation of regional wars, nation against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. When the United States is destroyed, the great tribulation wars shall commence. Daniel 7 verse 5, condensed. And suddenly another beast, a second, like a bear, had three ribs in its mouth between its teeth. Matthew 24 verse 7, and there will be famines, pestilences, and earthquakes in various places. Revelation 9 verse 18, by these three plagues, a third of mankind was killed by the fire and the smoke, and the brimstone. The three ribs in the bear's mouth and the famines, pestilences, and earthquakes spoken of by Yeshua, Jesus, and the plagues of fire, smoke, and brimstone of Revelation 9 verse 18 are one. The bear, Russia, will devour much flesh when it destroys the United States with its great nuclear sword, and when it does so, it will take peace from the earth, as the world's sole peacekeeping nation will no longer exist to deter and prevent regional wars from occurring throughout the world. Famines, pestilences, and earthquakes will follow the destruction of the United States, as will the fire, smoke, and brimstone of the Great Tribulation Wars. There will not be a two-sided World War III. Russia is prophesied to immobilize the United States with a surprise cyber and EMP attack, then suddenly destroy the United States. The United States will be immobilized and will not be able to launch a retaliatory nuclear strike against Russia. Scripture proclaims that there will be a great tribulation of regional wars, nation against nation and kingdom against kingdom. The Great Tribulation begins with the destruction of the United States. After America's destruction occurs, there will be no world superpower policeman, peacekeeper, to prevent nation from rising against nation and kingdom against kingdom. The nations of the earth will break out into many regional wars around the world during the Great Tribulation years. A great civilization is not conquered from without until it has destroyed itself from within. Isaiah 47 verse 5, "For you shall no longer be called the Lady of Kingdoms." Revelation 18 verse 23, "The light of a lamp shall not shine in you anymore." While Russia is prophesied to one day be the nuclear trigger man that destroys America, God claims that America's destruction is His judgment upon the land. Jeremiah 50, verse 9 through 15, with interpretation. "For behold, I will raise and cause to come up against Babylon, America, an assembly of great nations from the north country, Russia, and they shall array themselves against her, America. From there she shall be captured. Their arrows, hypersonic nuclear missiles, shall be like those of an expert warrior, precise. None shall return in vain. And Chaldea, America's military bases, equipment, vehicles, and weapons around the world, shall become plunder. All who plunder her, America, shall be satisfied, says Yahweh the Lord. Because you were glad, because you rejoiced in sin, you destroyers of my Judeo-Christian heritage, because you have grown fat like a heifer threshing grain, and you bellow like bulls, obese, entitlement-minded Americans, your mother, Catholic Church, shall be deeply ashamed. She who bore you, England, shall be ashamed. Behold, the least, youngest, of the end-time nations, America, shall be a wilderness, a dry land, and a desert. Because of the wrath of Yahweh the Lord, she, America, shall not be inhabited, but she, America, shall be wholly desolate. Everyone who goes by Babylon, America, shall be horrified and hiss at all her, America's, plagues. Put yourself in array against Babylon, America, all around. All you, artillery and missile military personnel who bend a bow, launch the missiles. Shoot at her, America. Spare no arrows, hypersonic nuclear missiles, for she, America, has sinned against Yahweh the Lord. Shout against her, America, all around. She, America, has given her hand. Her, America's Judeo-Christian foundations have fallen. Her, America's walls are thrown down. For it is the vengeance of Yahweh the Lord. Take vengeance on her. As she, America, has done, so do to her. Revelation 18, verse 5 through 8, with interpretation. For her, America's sins have reached to heaven, and God has remembered her, America's iniquities. Render to her, America, just as she rendered to you, nations, and repay her double according to her works of war. In the cup of war which she has mixed, mix double for her. In the measure that she, America, glorified herself and lived luxuriously, in the same measure give her torment and sorrow of war. For she, America, says in her heart, I sit as queen, Lady Liberty, leader of the free world, and am no helpless widow, and will not see sorrow of poverty and war. Therefore, her, America's plagues, will come in one day, death and mourning and famine, and she will be utterly burned with fire. For strong is Yahweh, the Lord, God, who judges her. Summation: the correlations of the end times beasts. The first beast of Daniel 7 begins as a lion with eagle's wings, the World War II alliance of Great Britain and the United States, which then formed the United Nations and NATO after World War II. The white horse of Revelation 6 and its rider represent NATO and the United States, respectively. The United States rides / leads NATO, the New World Order. The eagle's wings / rider of the white horse, the United States, is suddenly destroyed when the bear / rider of the red horse, Russia, suddenly destroys the United States. Thus, the deadly wound to one of the head nations of the multi-headed beast of Revelation 13 is the destruction of the United States by Russia. The bear / rider of the red horse, Russia, takes peace from the earth when it destroys the United States with its large sword, nuclear arsenal, and the Great Tribulation begins, as nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom in the Great Tribulation wars that follow. The three ribs in the bear's, Russia's, mouth, and the black horse represent the famines, pestilences, and earthquakes that accompany the Great Tribulation. The three ribs in the bear's, Russia's, mouth, and the pale horse also represent the fire, smoke, and brimstone of the Great Tribulation wars. The NATO beast / New World Order survives the deadly wound to its empire, the destruction of the United States, rapidly mobilizes, and becomes the third beast of Daniel 7. The third beast acquires four wings, replacing the eagle's wings that were plucked off when the United States was destroyed. The new wings represent the Franco-German alliance, which will financially, industrially, militarily, and politically support the NATO beast. The four heads of the third beast represent the rise of the Fourth German Reich through the NATO beast. Sometime during the Great Tribulation years, Russia will lead a Gog/Magog invasion into Israel, which will ultimately result in Russia's western border coastland cities being destroyed. After Russia's main cities are destroyed, the fourth and final beast of Daniel 7 will emerge from the third beast, the final Roman Empire. Pre-trib, post-trib, or no raptures. People who insist that there will not be a rapture because God does not rapture us from tribulation are missing a key understanding. God allows the righteous to go through tribulation, even the great tribulation, but God does not judge the righteous with the wicked. Noah found grace in God's eyes, and God saved Noah and his family on the ark when he flooded the world in judgment. Lot, a righteous man, and his family were escorted out of Sodom before God rained down fire on Sodom in judgment. America's New World Order, deep state globalists, are the destroyers of America's Judeo-Christian heritage. As such, God will destroy America and the unrepentant sinners dwelling within America in judgment. Righteous living American saints will be taken out of America before God judges the United States of America with fire. The three raptures. There will be three major end times raptures. The rapture of 144,000 Messianic Jews from Israel, the American rapture, and the world rapture. The three measures of meal that Yeshua, Jesus, spoke of in the parable of the leaven are three major end times raptures. The three measures of meal that a woman took and hid are the three major raptures of the end times saints. The first rapture, 144,000 Messianic Jews from Israel. 144,000 Messianic Jews of Israel will be the first people raptured and redeemed from the earth, the first fruits to stand before God. To Israel first, then the other nations. As of the Gregorian calendar year 2022, there are currently about 50,000 Messianic Jews dwelling in Israel. The number of Yeshua, Jesus, believing Jews living in Israel will increase through childbearing, conversion, and immigration to 144,000 by about the year 2037, 70 years after Israel's victory of the Six-Day War in 1967. It will be in the year 2037 or thereabout that 144,000 Messianic Jews of Israel will be raptured as the first fruits to stand before God. The second rapture, the American rapture. Righteous Americans will be the second group of people raptured and redeemed from the earth to stand before God. Come out of her, my people, Revelation 18 verse 4, is a clarion call from Almighty God to the American saints to come out of Babylon, America, in the American rapture. God saying, my people, go out of the midst of her, Jeremiah 51 verse 45, and come out of her, my people, Revelation 18 verse 4, are one, a reference to the American rapture. My people, go out of the midst of her, and come out of her, my people, is the same type of language God uses when he raptures the two witnesses, as he says, come up here, and the two witnesses ascend in a cloud to heaven. The third rapture, the world rapture. The righteous saints of the world, excluding the raptured Israeli and American saints, will have to endure and survive the Great Tribulation years. The Great Tribulation and the seven-year reign of the Anti-Messiah, Antichrist, run consecutively, but they are not the same time periods. The righteous saints of the world will have to endure the Great Tribulation and the first half of the reign of the Anti-Messiah, Antichrist. The day of the world rapture will come when the man of sin, Anti-Messiah, Antichrist, is revealed, sits in the rebuilt temple of God in Jerusalem, and declares to the world that he is God. Why three raptures? The first rapture of 144,000 Messianic Jews from Israel is pre-tribulation. As God has declared, salvation is to the Jew first, then the Greek. Yahwehite is the Hebrew word for Greek in Romans 1 verse 16, meaning a person who has broken free from the bondage of sin and has become a follower of the way. The second rapture of righteous Americans is pre-tribulation, as the Great Tribulation officially begins with the destruction of the United States. The destruction of the United States is judgment from God upon America, and God does not judge the righteous with the wicked. Due to America's destruction being a judgment from God, he will provide a rapture for the American saints to come out of America before the nuclear bombs detonate upon the land. Unrighteous Americans will be left behind and will be incinerated in the nuclear blasts, and the corpses of left behind unrighteous Americans will become food for unclean birds and beasts. The third rapture is post-tribulation, halfway through the reign of the anti-Messiah, Antichrist. God does not rapture saints out of tribulation, even the Great Tribulation, but sees his saints through tribulation. God will rapture the saints of the world before judgment comes upon the world through the anti-Messiah, Antichrist, who will execute via guillotine anyone who does not receive his 666, Mark of the Beast, in order to buy and sell. The left behind of the world, who were left behind because they did not believe in Yeshua, Jesus, or were living in unrepentant sin, will still have an opportunity to come out of the world and be with God. But in order to do so, they will need to refuse the Mark of the Beast and lay down their lives to be beheaded via guillotine. Wars and rumors of wars. Matthew 24, verse 6, "And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet." The onset of Cold War II has begun with Russia's invasion of Ukraine on February 24th, 2022, and there will be wars and rumors of wars, as there already has been some nuclear saber-rattling talk between America and Russia, and there is sure to be more of that in the coming years. But the destruction of the United States will not come to pass until the destruction of Damascus, Syria, is fulfilled. First comes the destruction of Damascus, Syria, then America. Isaiah 17, verse 1, "Behold, Damascus will cease from being a city, and it will be a ruinous heap." Jeremiah 50, verse 18, with interpretation. "Therefore, thus says Yahweh the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, behold, I will punish the king of Babylon, president of the United States, and his land, America, as I have punished the king of Assyria, president of Syria, and his city, Damascus." A warning from God. Genesis 41, verse 32. "The dream was repeated to Pharaoh twice, because the thing is established by God, and God will shortly bring it to pass."
God has revealed to Pharaoh what he intends to do.
Yes?
Pharaoh's dreams are one and the same.
Just as the two dreams of Pharaoh were one and the same, conveying the same message, the prophetic dreams and visions of the beasts in Daniel chapter 7 and Revelation chapter 6 and 13 are one and the same, conveying the same message.
I am certain that Pharaoh has been blessed by a warning from the Lord himself.
The prophetic dreams and visions concerning the end times are a warning from God to all people of the world just as Pharaoh's dreams were a warning from God concerning the drought and famine that were soon to come upon Egypt. Scripture Truth Ministries predicts that Damascus will cease from being a city during the Tetrad blood moons of 2033 to 2034, and the destruction of the United States will occur a decade later during the Tetrad blood moons of 2043 to 2044. The destruction of Damascus, Syria, the destruction of the United States of America, the Great Tribulation Wars that follow, and the reign of the Anti-Messiah, Antichrist, are established in Scripture and cannot be prevented. What are believers to do in these last days?
Assume then that your reading is accurate. Is there nothing we can do to prevent this disaster?
Yes, Master, there is.
How?
Pharaoh must select a wise and honest man and set him above the land of Egypt. He must see that Pharaoh's overseers collect a fifth of all that is produced during the years of plenty and store it for use during the years of famine. In that way, Egypt will not be destroyed by the drought.
Is there no other way to avert disaster?
No, Master.
Believers in these end times should heed the warnings from Scripture prophecy and make preparations for the coming Great Tribulation, which will be followed by the seven-year reign of the Anti-Messiah, Antichrist, just as Joseph instructed Pharaoh to prepare for the drought and famine that were to come upon the land of Egypt. Luke 21, verse 34 through 35. Take heed to yourselves, lest your hearts be weighed down with carousing, drunkenness, and cares of this life, and that day come on you unexpectedly. For it will come as a snare on all those who dwell on the face of the whole earth. Syrian believers. Many Syrian believers have already departed Syria, and the Syrian government has become increasingly hostile towards Christians living in Syria during the last few years, which is further driving the exodus from Syria. Damascus's destruction is God's judgment. Therefore, righteous Syrian believers will be led out of Damascus. Believers living in or near Damascus should make plans to exit the city as soon as possible. There will not be a Syrian rapture. Syrian believers will need to wait upon the world rapture. Israeli believers. 144,000 Israeli believers will be raptured, redeemed from among men upon the earth, and will be the first fruits to stand before Yeshua, Jesus. These Messianic Jews are virgins of the wicked ways of the world. The 144,000 are believers who obey the commandments of God and believe in Yeshua, Jesus, as their Messiah and Savior. To all Messiah-denying Jews living in Israel, in order to be part of the first 144,000 that are to be redeemed to God, you must accept Yeshua Jesus as Messiah and Savior. Once the number of Messianic Jews living in Israel reaches 144,000, they will be raptured to Mount Zion to be with God, and the remaining Jews of Israel will be left behind. The Messiah-denying, commandment-keeping Jews living in Israel who want to be part of the first 144,000 redeemed and those who are left behind must accept Yeshua, Jesus, as Messiah and Savior, as no one goes to the Father except through Him. American believers. Americans, believe in Yeshua, Jesus. Repent and obey the commandments of God. The United States may be a sinking ship, but Americans do not have to go down with her. America's righteous saints will be taken in the American rapture and will not be incinerated in the nuclear destruction of the United States, nor die from the nuclear radiation afterward. Many unrighteous living Americans will die in America's destruction, and those who survive the nuclear blasts will die from nuclear fallout radiation and become food for the unclean birds and beasts of the earth. Russian believers. It is prophesied that Russia, during the Great Tribulation years, will lead an invasion into Israel and will be defeated. The border coastland cities of Russia will afterward be destroyed. The destruction of Russia's border coastland cities is God's judgment. Therefore, righteous Russian believers will be led out of Russia's cities. Believers dwelling in the coastland cities of Russia during the Great Tribulation should consider moving into sparsely populated Russian mainland regions. There will not be a Russian rapture. Russian believers will need to wait upon the world rapture. World believers. Believers of the world, those who are not taken in the Israeli and American raptures, will have to live through and endure the Great Tribulation years. The Great Tribulation years will be a time of great war, poverty, pestilence, and famine. Joseph advised Pharaoh to store up food during Egypt's 7 years of abundance, so that food would be available during the 7 years of famine coming to the land of Egypt. Likewise, believers of the world should store up non-perishable food for themselves before the Great Tribulation years, so that food will be available during the Great Tribulation. It is prophesied that during the Great Tribulation years, there will be severe rationing of food, and a day's wages will purchase the equivalent of a loaf of bread. Scripture Truth Ministries predicts that the destruction of Damascus will occur in 2033 to 2034, and then believers of the world will have a decade to store non-perishable food before the destruction of the United States in 2043 to 2044, which will be followed by the Great Tribulation. All believers. The righteous are being taken to a spaceship in the clouds. Psalm 91, verse 4 through 8, condensed with interpretation. He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow, nuclear missile, that flies by day, nor of the nuclear destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes shall you look, see the reward of the wicked. No evil shall befall you, for he shall give his angels charge over you. In their hands they shall bear you up. Luke 17, verse 32. Remember Lot's wife. When raptured, remember Lot's wife and don't look back. We are all sinners, worthy of death, but have been given grace by the blood of Yeshua, Jesus. As sinners, worthy of death, we are not to look upon God's judgment until after his judgment is fulfilled, and then we can see the end result of his judgment. Noah was shut inside of the ark, and the ark rose above the waters. The Hebrews covered their doorposts with lamb's blood, shut their doors, and did not open their doors until the next morning, as God executed judgment upon all the firstborn of all Egypt. Lot and his family were escorted out of Sodom, but Lot's wife looked back at God's judgment upon Sodom, and she was turned into a pillar of salt. Isaiah 26, verse 20, with interpretation. Come, my people, enter your chambers and shut your doors behind you. Hide yourself from the world, as it were, for a little moment, until the indignation, 7-year reign of the anti-Messiah, Antichrist, is past. Righteous messianic Israeli Jews will be redeemed from among men in a pre-tribulation rapture, first to Mount Zion and then to the clouds. Righteous Americans will be taken in a pre-tribulation rapture, first to Mount Zion and then to the clouds. The world rapture will be post-tribulation, occurring midway through the 7-year reign of the anti-Messiah, Antichrist, and the righteous saints of the world will be raptured directly to the clouds. The left behind, who become saints and are beheaded, will not spend any time in the grave, as they will be instantly transported upon death to the clouds. Luke 21, verse 36. Watch therefore, and pray always, that you may be counted worthy to escape all these things that will come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man. Believe in Yeshua, Jesus. Repent. Obey God's commandments. Live righteously. Watch for the end time signs. And pray that you may be counted worthy to soon stand before the Son of God, Yeshua the Messiah, Jesus the Christ. Revelation 21, verses 7 and 20. Behold, I am coming quickly. Blessed is he who keeps the words of the prophecy of this book. Surely I am coming quickly.